In part 3 of our lesson on law of cosines, you will learn how to use Heron's formula. Heron's formula finds the area of a triangle when all three sides are known. This is a really powerful and easy to use tool. Think back to your geometry days for a minute. The only way you could find the area of a triangle was to do 1/2 of the base times the height. Now that meant you couldn't find the area of that triangle unless you knew what that height was. But what Heron's formula allows you to do is find the area just by knowing all three sides of the triangle. Heron's formula uses a special number, S, which stands for semi-perimeter. Semi, as you may know, means half, so semi-perimeter is just half the perimeter. So to find S, we would just do A plus B plus C and divide it by 2. Now to find the area of the triangle, we take the square root of the product of 4 numbers. And those 4 numbers are S, S minus A, S minus B, and S minus C. So we just have to find those 4 numbers, multiply them, then take the square root of that number, and that will give us the area of the triangle. So let's try that on this next example problem. Suppose you want to plant grass seed on a triangular property whose side lengths are 100 yards, 78 yards, and 116 yards. Well, let's draw a little picture. We've got sides of 100 yards, 78 yards, and 116 yards. We are told that each bag of grass seed covers 800 square feet of the ground, and we are being asked how many bags of grass seed must be purchased in order to cover your entire property with grass seed. Well, in order to solve this problem, we need to know the area of our property. And because we know all three sides of our property, we can use Heron's formula to find the area. So we know that Heron's formula uses that special number, S, the semi-perimeter, and S means we have to add up the three sides, so we're going to do 100 plus 78 plus 116 and divide that by 2. We find out that that is 147. Now to find the area of the triangle, we will take the square root of the product of those 4 numbers. So remember, we have to take S, which is 147, and then we have to take that times S, subtracted by each of the sides. So we will do 147 minus 100 and multiply that times 147 minus 78 and multiply that by 147 minus 116. That becomes the square root of 147 times 147 minus 100 is 47. 147 minus 78 is 69. And finally, 147 minus 116 is 31. So now we can take the square root of all of that. We can do second square root 147 times 47 times 69 times 31. Close that parenthesis for the square root. And we get 3844.26. And now let's think about our units here. The lengths of the sides were in yards, so that means the area of our property is in square yards. Now we want to determine the number of bags of grass seed that we're going to need. And we are told that each bag of grass seed covers 800 square feet. Now the area that we found was in square yards, so we will need to convert that to square feet. You want to be careful here, because while it's true that there are 3 feet per yard, there are not 3 square feet per 1 square yard. All you need to do is make a little picture for yourself, and I think you'll see it pretty easily. So let's think about this grass seed now. Think of this, if we have 1 square yard here, we know it would be 1 yard by 1 yard, and we know that each yard is 3 feet. So this yard is 3 feet, and this yard is 3 feet. So hopefully you can see then that this 1 square yard is going to equal 9 square feet, because it's 3 by 3. So if we convert the area to square feet, we will have to multiply it by 9. So we'll take that 3844.26 square yards and multiply it by a conversion factor of 1 square yard in the bottom is 9 square feet in the top. Punching that into our calculator, we find out that the area is 34,598.34 square feet. Now we will be able to determine the number of bags of grass seed we will need. We know we have 34,598.34 square feet, and that's going to be divided by the 800 square feet per bag. So you can see the units will work out. If we were to multiply by the reciprocal, the bag would go into the numerator. Feet squared are going to cancel feet squared. Let's enter this on our calculators now. We see that we are going to get 43.24 bags. Now, you know, when you head over to the store, you can't ask them to sell you 43.24 bags of grass seed. I don't think they'll cut open a bag of grass seed so that you can have 0.24 of it. So I think we'll have to end up buying 44 bags of grass seed. Since this was a word problem, we should write our answer in a sentence. You can say something simple, maybe 44 bags of grass seed must be purchased to cover the yard. Something along those lines.